I am going to be talking to you about my work on enhancing lactation with biologics to improve infant and maternal health. Babies are born to breastfeed. It is the biological norm of all mammals, and it is the everyday standard of care for infant nutrition in every nation. But the problem is, 50% of lactating parents, they struggle to make enough milk, and the only other choice for most parents is to use infant formula. And you could have enough infant formula in the world to feed every single baby on the planet, but you cannot use it if you do not have safe water. If you have no safe water, if you have no electricity because you're in an emergency situation, baby formula is deadly. You see, bacteria loves baby formula, and baby formula and infant bottles are not sterile. And so when it gets contaminated with bacteria, it can make your babies really sick and it can kill them. This picture is from Pakistan, and here, there is no safe water. Last year, a third of Pakistan was underwater because of heavy monsoon flooding, and these are satellite images of the region. There's no safe water, and the Minister of Health came out and said, and I'm paraphrasing, "Stop sending us formula. It is deadly to our babies. We have no safe water, and what we need to do is help lactating parents make more milk." These disasters are increasing in scale, frequency, and intensity all over the world. And in the US, they're hitting us hard. So if you're in a disaster situation where you can't use infant formula, what are you to do? With our current methods, not in a disaster situation, it can take 4 to 6 weeks to see an increase in milk supply. That's too long, not acceptable, and we can do better. You see, increasing milk supply basically boils down to increasing levels of prolactin. Prolactin is a naturally occurring hormone that is a strong driver of lactation. And your body only makes prolactin when infants are mechanically stimulating your breasts by suckling. The issue with prolactin is that it's too small and you pee it out quickly. So you constantly have to be breastfeeding in order to maintain or increase your levels of prolactin. And a nice solution here would be just to create a prolactin that lasts longer in the body. And what I find so infuriating about this problem is that we've had the solution to solve it for probably 20 years. It's really simple. We use it all the time in protein engineering, and about 13 FDA-approved drugs already use it. All we have to do is make prolactin bigger. We fuse another protein to it to give it some bulk so it can't be peed out. And I'm gonna call our bigger prolactin, prolactin XL. We made prolactin XL in the lab, we injected it into mice, and we did find it last longer. We increased the half-life of prolactin from 1 minute to almost 3 days. When we injected prolactin XL into lactating mice, we found that it made milk cells bigger because the cells had more milk-making machinery and were engorged with milk. Because we have bigger cells, we have bigger mammaries. And some of these mammaries were so big, I had problems putting them on a glass slide. But this is really exciting, right? So all we did was we made a bigger hormone, we made bigger milk cells, bigger mammaries, bigger pups. And so what I really like about this biologic, it's something that can be used every day to bolster breastfeeding, but it can also be stockpiled and stored like vaccines and essential medicines for emergency situations. And there's a lot of power to that. If you start breastfeeding to recommendations, like worldwide, you can save $1 billion per day and almost 1 million lives per year. It's also really great for the environment, because infant formula is largely made from dairy, and we all know dairy is bad for the planet. This is also important to me because someday I will be a mom. And just like my mom, I want to breastfeed my children. The odds are against me, and the reality is I will probably struggle to breastfeed my children, probably like a lot of you in the audience. I don't like that my only other choice is to use infant formula, so I'm making a new one.